And 20 years from now, 30 years from now, will your knowledge that you have gained here or anywhere in the world help? You don't. Knowledge that you have got, is it going to help? For example, mechanical engineering student, you have learned internal combustion engines. Internal combustion engine runs all the vehicles today. Right? You start with that. You learn it very well. You work in an organization, Tata Motors, for example, or Mahindra, and you must remember internal combustion engines. Are you sure internal combustion engines are going to be there? May not. 10 years from now, there may be all cars running in fuel cells and not on combustion engines. Then what happens to your expertise? What happens to what you have learned in the university? What happens to the experience that you have gained in the industry? What happens to that? It's of no use. So do I need to say that all you have learned in the university is useless? No. I don't need to say that. What I need to say is what is most important today is not the subject you have learned, but learning how to learn. Because in the 30, 40 years to come, you are not going to use, it's not like our times, 40 years back, when industry was there producing the same stuff year after year. We had ambassador car, Mark 1, Mark 2, Mark 3, Mark 4, nothing changed, not even a nut bolt to change. And so, it was a mundane and everybody used to say, experience is important. Actually today, experience is misleading. Past experience is not an indicator of what is going to happen in future. And hence, what is important is not experience. What is important is your ability to learn now or not. By coming to this point, getting a degree, actually, you have come to the bottom of the hill. The hill is learning. Now you have to start climbing that one. What do I mean by that? See, my biodata was read up. It was said, I am doing on nano suspension research. I am doing research on biology, on cancer. Who taught me? My B.Tech? No. My M.Tech? No. My Ph.D.? No. My postdoc? No. Nobody taught me in these areas. I had to learn it myself. Why? Because I could see the writing in the wall. I knew these other things which are coming. And so, I had to get acquainted with them. I had to grab them. I had to embrace them. And so, what was helpful for me? Now, that's why I am trying to tell that your learning in this institute is not useless. Because this institute has taught you a very important thing. How to learn? How to learn a subject? Tomorrow, the subject may change, but the method of learning doesn't change. You have to go to the library. You have to look online materials. Even in future, the mode of learning may change. But the spirit of learning and the endeavor of a human being, the passion of a person to learn is more important. Because nothing comes out without a dream. And what is a dream? A.P.J. Abdul Kalam said, well, please remember, don't make a mistake. Please don't get Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam. Abdul Kalam was not a doctor. Have you seen, you know, he is not a doctor. What is coming up? Have you seen the Olympic running event? I will pick up two events, 100 meter run and marathon. Now, the journalist comes, the photographers come. They have focused the lens. He is focusing on me. And the Rio Olympic journalist will focus on the athletes. But where do they focus on? Well, it is 100 meter run. They focus at the starting block. Why? Because you are going to run only for 9.7 seconds. So in 9.7 seconds, if you lose 0.1 or 0.2 seconds in the beginning, you are gone. It's very difficult to make it up. But have you ever seen that a journalist focuses at the starting point of a marathon event? Never. Because you are going to run for 40 kilometers and you are going to run for 2.5 hours. So that 0.1 second at the beginning really doesn't matter. What matters is, do you have stamina? Can you survive 40 kilometers? And so where they focus? They focus in the middle level, and then finally they focus when after the city, the athletes enter the stadium. They focus there. That on the gate, who is coming up? My dear friend, life is not a 100-meter run. Life is a marathon. So, what I'm trying to say is, it doesn't matter whether you start in Indus University, IIT Madras, IIT Kanpur, IIT Bombay, or NIT Surakar. It really doesn't matter where you start. Because it's a marathon, the starting point is not important. What is important? What is important is where you end up. I mean, you may say, no sir, they at the beginning got lot of advantages, right, which we didn't get. How can we catch them up? Because they will always be ahead of us. Well, then I have to prove it with example. Now let me look for examples. Well, the easiest example available is the person who is speaking in front of you. I don't have an IIT degree, nor do I have a foreign degree. I don't have them. I got it from a state university. And with humbleness, with humility, I can tell you, 20 years I have been professor of an IIT. I have been dean of an IIT, and now I am leading an IIT. Without any IIT degree, without any degree from abroad. I can do that. And even I have got the best technological institution in the world, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, where I was offered to stay back, which I didn't, because I liked my country. And hence, my dear friends, really it doesn't matter where you start your career. And in fact, this university is a very good place to start with. The kind of care that they have taken on you, I think good enough. The amount of input at this stage, at 20, 22 years, the kind of knowledge that is required for success is there with you. Now, the question is, again, I go back to Abdul Kalam. Are you ready to spend sleepless nights? If you are ready to spend, you can make anything. You can be a Nobel laureate. That's what I'm trying to tell. Don't think that, you know, people come from the sky. I am teaching IIT students. There are all kinds of students there as well. So, we come to the most important point. Now, that is, we have already seen that the world is going to change. So it will depend on whether you are ready to learn with that. Whether you are happy to be with the degree that you have received today, or you are unhappy, you want to learn more. That's what is the point. And for that, I actually advise you that take a higher degree. Take a master's.